Hello, I'm Scott Scotsman, and today we're going to talk about economics. And we're going to talk about sellers with and without price discrimination. And today we're going to have Professor Mark McNeil to talk about economics.
Here we are in beautiful Baja, Tustin, at the McNeil International Film Studios headquarters. And the topic is a price searcher who charges one price compared to a price discriminating price searcher. One, in this case, we're talking about price discrimination, perfect price discrimination, where everybody gets charged the highest price they're willing to pay, versus a firm that cannot price discriminate and must charge everyone the same price. With one price, no price discrimination, marginal revenue has twice the slope of the demand curve. And if we get a marginal cost curve here, let's make it both the same. There's marginal cost and there's marginal cost. So marginal cost. We would produce where marginal cost equals marginal revenue. This is the quantity. And up to the demand curve for the price, P1, Q1. Now, let's look at these areas here. If the firm does not price discriminate, its total revenue will be this green area, price times quantity. And the difference between price and opportunity cost, this on each unit, is the producer surplus. Down here is the opportunity cost of producing each of these units. So that rectangle here is opportunity cost. And this little area right there, it's the difference between what a buyer is willing to pay and what they actually pay, that is the price. And this represents, do you people know? Huh? Pay attention. Put that phone down. All right, so this is, what is it again? That's it, consumer surplus. Good job. Now, there's a little missing piece of this puzzle right there. Look at that little triangle. This triangle represents all of the trades that are not done where somebody values it more than the opportunity cost of producing it. All of these are examples of lost wealth because the quantity is restricted from what it would be in a purely competitive environment, which is this somewhat. Okay, and so this is dead weight loss. Now, let's turn the seller into a perfect price discriminator. Perfect price discriminator. That means they will charge each person who buys it the maximum they are willing to pay for it. Something like when you go to buy a car. Do they try and figure out what is the maximum you will pay? Or if you go to college and you apply for financial aid, they want to charge you the highest you're willing to pay. So if that's the case, then demand is the same as marginal revenue. With perfect price discrimination, demand is the same as marginal revenue. And so they would produce as long as the marginal revenue exceeds the marginal cost. All of these get produced until there, and this will be the price discriminator's quantity and the price. There's not one price. There are all these different prices. Everybody gets charged a different price with perfect price discrimination. So this entire red stripey area is total revenue to this firm. Do you see that it's bigger? Do you see? And this area right here is above, the opportunity cost of producing each of these units. So the area of opportunity cost is that. And then all of the area beneath price, but above opportunity cost, represents this firm's producer surplus. So we have producer surplus that area, opportunity cost that area, and what is missing here? Two things are missing. One is there is no consumer surplus. Consumers are paying the maximum they're willing to pay, so there's no consumer surplus. Is that good or bad? Exactly. But neither is there any deadweight loss. So all of the resources are allocated correctly, and all of the wealth-creating trades between producers, that's these guys, and consumers, that's those guys, all of those wealth-creating trades are being made with perfect price discrimination. So there we have it. One price, boom, different marginal revenue, that's the quantity price, total revenue is that amount, consumer surplus, producer surplus, opportunity cost, and good old deadweight loss here. But with perfect price discrimination, the demand curve, which shows price is marginal revenue, they will produce where marginal revenue equals marginal cost, that's that quantity, and they have taken all of the consumer surplus, but they have eliminated,
consumer surplus?
Close, no cigar, baby. They have eliminated the deadweight loss. That's right. Okay. Grazie, grazie, grazie.